What is the good word, YouTube family? Guys, future tomorrow here, back with another vid. And today we're just gonna take a quick look, really, really quick look. We're not gonna go into all the crazy details of the Air Max 90 silhouette and its history, even though it is celebrating a 25th anniversary in 2015. Most of you, I would imagine, or hope by now, have either seen like enough Air Max 90 videos to last you guys a lifetime, or B, you actually own Air Max 90s, so you're like, yeah, okay, we've seen this model and silhouette, dude, like, we know the whole history. But, yeah, so not a crazy review. I just want to share a couple, like, little details, some information with you guys, I guess. These did drop on May the 15th on Nike.com. Some of the models, if not all the models, actually, and I believe the clothes as well, sold out almost immediately. I had a pair in cart, but got the dreaded message that they were out of stock. The item is no longer available. So luckily they were, I had a tab open with them on titolo.ch, and I ended up grabbing this pair from there. Obviously at the higher price point, because titolo.ch along with Wellgosh are two of the most expensive shops that I personally have ever shopped at. Like, both are really expensive, but titolo.ch in particular tends to get a lot of heat before other shops or other destinations do, but they're just expensive. That's the only deal with them. And given I live obviously in the US, picking them up can be quite a not quite a challenge, but it's just pricier. Also when you consider, or when you factor in, I'm sorry, the actual shipping cost as well. So again, like, what really did it for me on these guys was the Merlin print, which is what this print is called. It first appeared on a scarf that Liberty had basically worked on in 1972, and I don't think they had ever used it in any other piece of clothing or item ever since, but it has made a reappearance in 2015. But for this entire pack. Now, what's this pack that I'm talking about? So we're gonna have like some weird lighting effects here as like the back zooms out, but we kind of just like look at some of the different offerings. I mean, you have Rifts, you have Theas, you know, there's like so many models that, you know, Liberty and Nike, or Nike, collabed on for this effort or for this pack. In the pack also, guys, you have jackets, you have shirts also. You know, you can see the shirt there. If I just get this a little bit closer, and what do I have picking? Okay, we have popping up a delivery message about a pair of shoes that's coming in, more shoes again. You can see you have hats. I mean, so really, really interesting pack, guys. I mean, you know, again, Liberty and Nike, or Nike with their long-standing relationship, they do really brilliant work in my personal opinion. Some of the stuff definitely leans more, all the stuff, or the majority of the stuff they do, tends to be exclusively for women. But this pack, I believe, in my opinion, is a bit, or unisex, but again, that's my personal opinion. I just absolutely love this print on the shoe. It's really, really beautiful. The Merlin print, I mean, really, really nice. So for those of you that don't know, Liberty is basically a shop or boutique in the UK that is on Regent Street, if I'm not mistaken, that opened in 1875. And ever since then, guys, to current or modern times, they've always offered some really beautiful fabrics with some really nice prints on them. And this pack is by no means any exception. I think that these are just absolutely beautiful. So since I'm not going to review the 90 in full detail, what is this video about? So the video is about part of the knowledge that I just dropped for you guys as far as what this print is called, who's responsible for it, that being Liberty. The model obviously is the Air Max 90. The brand is Nike. And as far as the details on the shoe, what I really like, again, the print. And then if you look at the front of the toe box here, and even the underlay or the overlay, like right underneath this part of the mud guard, this milky type of like plastic transparent material, that overlay, guys, really, really does it for me personally on this shoe. I mean, really, really nice touch. I love these little stripes that it did here as well. I mean, that's like really, it's not as like crazy as like True Dazzle Camo, which hopefully you guys may know like some of the history of Dazzle Camouflage, but it almost like starts to have that Dazzle Camo type of effect. But it's really just parallel stripes at the end of the day. Maybe not even anything as crazy as getting into Dazzle Camo, to be honest. But again, so that clear overlay. And then like, you know, the print and this lever right here, this material on the mud guard that extends to the mid and goes to the back. Guys, it's a dimpled lever. If the camera goes into some macro love force, you guys can see the detail on that really closely. I mean, that material is just simply beautiful. It appears to be real leather, not synthetic leather. And again, it has that nice dimple texture in it. So I love the texture. The print one more time. You know, the stripes right there almost begins to, but probably not really like a dazzle camo. But again, that's probably wrong on my part to even say that. So just parallel stripes, but again, beautiful nonetheless. And then right here, the signature part of the Air Max 90, where the unit is, and then the front toe cap right here. You can see it more clearly underneath on the outsole. But that smoky black, you know, translucent material or plastic rubber, if you will, I'm sorry, really does it for me. I love that smoky rubber material or look. Like, I think it just like goes so well on the shoe. The only two things on the shoe I'm not a fan of, but it obviously didn't stop me from picking them up. This shiny black swoosh, yeah, I'm not so much with the shininess on that. Like, I'm not really sure about that at the end of the day. But it is what it is. Obviously, again, did not stop me from picking these up. The other thing that I am gonna do to these that I'm not a fan of is these laces, these waxed thinner flat laces. I'm not a fan of those. I have in my eBay store some wider, just regular flat wax laces, but it's the regular width or the standard width of you know, flat laces. It also has like some little gold tips or aglets on the ends. I'm gonna actually swap these out for those. I think the gold is gonna accent really well with the Merlin print and with the overall white that you find throughout like the shoe itself. So that's pretty much it. I mean, again, this is a US, this is a women's shoe. The whole package is exclusively for women. This is a US 12, which is gonna fit like a really snug, really tight US 10 and a half, if you will. So it's, and again, with how tight and snug it's going to be, it's not that forgiving. Obviously, the more you wear a shoe, it's going to start to like kind of stretch out a bit, which will help that fact. But yeah, Air Max 90, part of the Liberty, you know, pack with Nike or Nike. But yeah, just absolutely beautiful shoe, in my personal opinion. You don't have to agree with that. And again, guys, always pick up just what you like, not because a reviewer, big or small, says that they like it and they're gonna pick it up. You know, just do what you like at the end of the day. Questions, comments, thoughts, concerns. I noticed that again, these are sitting in a couple of sizes on Tidelo. Why didn't you pick them up? Did you like the Thea better, the Rift, any of the other models that I just showed on my phone? Was something else more attractive to you? Let me know. Let me know in the comments what you guys really think about these at the end of the day. I am probably going to pick up the Thea if I can find them in a US 12, but I was trying to avoid Tilo again just because of how expensive they are. These already cost quite a bit. So if I picked up the Theas and these at the same time, that would have been quite a hit. You know, I think we're almost close to like $370, maybe $400 for just two shoes. That's definitely quite a bit. But anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching. This is Future Tomorrow, and until the next vid, I'm out. Peace.